supporting men's health for Movember. This week on The Wire, investors wake up to emerging boom, prices continue to rise in October, and Aussies save $100 billion in 7 months. G'day guys, my name's Tim Guest, and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate where you can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment, and more. Now please like, comment, and share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. So let's kick it off with our top story for this week. Investors wake up to emerging boom. So the many strong property markets around Australia have been uplifted primarily by owner-occupiers, including first home buyers. But the latest loans data suggests that investors are starting to join the buying trend. So the number of property investor loan commitments has returned to pre-pandemic levels, and that's according to figures from the Australian Bureau of Statistics. So the ABS lending indicators for September indicates that more than $5 billion of new investor loan commitments were recorded that month, a similar value to February 2020 before the onset of the pandemic impact. Now, the number of investor loan commitments also increased 5% in September after recording a monthly rise of 9% in August, and that's all according to the Australian Bureau of Statistics. Real estate professionals across Australia report rising activity from investors who are increasingly aware of strong markets with rising prices and very low vacancy rates, particularly in the smaller cities and regional Australia. And now guys, for our next story, prices continue to rise in October. So real estate prices continue to defy the pandemic recession in October, with the latest CoreLogic data showing that 13 of the nation's 15 market jurisdictions were delivering growth in their median house prices. 7 of the 8 capital cities, so that's all except Melbourne, recorded house price growth in October, as did 6 of the 7 state regional markets, so that was all except regional South Australia. The national average was a 0.5% rise in house prices, with combined regional up 7.9%, outperforming the combined capitals up 0.4%. Now this follows a similarly bullish result during September and confirms the figures published last week by Domain, which found that every capital city except Melbourne produced house price growth in the September quarter. In annual terms, all 8 capital cities have house prices higher than a year ago, led by Canberra up 7.3%, Sydney up 7.2%, and Hobart up 6.9%. Darwin, Brisbane, and Adelaide have all had annual growth in the 4 to 5% range. But the leading jurisdiction, I should say, for annual growth in house prices is regional Tasmania, up 10%. Regional New South Wales and regional Queensland have also risen about 6%. Now, guys, for our final story of the week, Aussies save $100 billion in 7 months. So Australians have amassed $115 billion in total savings as a buffer against the pandemic recession, in a sign that economic recovery could be derailed by any future reduction in government income support. APRA figures show household deposits surged to $1.09 trillion by the end of September, an increase of $115 billion in 12 months and $99.5 billion increase on deposit levels in February before the pandemic took hold. NAB Director of Market Economics, Tapas Strickland, says that just as the tens of billions in emergency support helped soften the virus recession, the savings amassed recently will help households navigate any drop-off in income payments over the coming months. There is mounting optimism the economy is recovering after a 7% contraction in the June quarter. RBA Deputy Governor Guy Debelle said last week he expected the economy to have grown in the September quarter, which technically would be the end of the pandemic recession. Surveys show that outside of Victoria, consumer confidence has staged a dramatic recovery to sit at pre-pandemic levels. Well, guys, they're the top stories for the week. Now, please don't forget to like, comment, and share this video, and subscribe or follow wherever you are seeing this. Have a great week, and remember, guys, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that's action. Thanks a lot, and bye for now.